I will give just according to the title, tropical version of Hilbert polynomial. And so I start first with some basic concepts, just to remind the basic concepts of the tropical algebra. Okay, so the main object of the tropical algebra is tropical semiring, and it is endowed with its semiring, endowed with two operations, and it's important with respect to addition in the tropical semiring. And actually, the usual main source of tropical semirings is an ordered semigroups. So if T is the ordered semigroup, and then it's inherited a structure of tropical semiring, where E is a addition, you consider the minimum, and as the multiplication, you consider the group semigroup operation. If additionally, it is not only semi, and it's on T is not only group, say in a semi group, but rather a group, then it's a tropical semi skew field. So have division, tropical division, so which is the subtraction in the group, and if it is additionally a abelian, then you can talk about tropical semi-field. So with respect to the tropical division, which is the subtraction in the group, just the typical examples are the say non-negative integers or the non-negative integers with the added infinity. These are the examples of the commutative tropical semirings, and the infinity plays a role of the neutral element, and in its turn the zero plays a role of the unity. And if you consider not only the non-negative, but all the say integers, all the respective integers with the added infinity, you can talk about the semi-fields. And an example of a non-commutative tropical semiring is the n by n matrices, say over any of these semirings or semifields, with the usual operation on the product, tropical product of matrices, which mimics the classical classical multiplication of matrices. Okay, this was a notion of the tropical semiring, and another important notion is the tropical polynomial. So to define tropical polynomial, we, as in the classical world, we start with a tropical monomial, so with the product of variable I times. And more generally, a monomial is the tropical product of powers of variables, and with the product, tropical product with the coefficient A, and one can talk about its tropical degree, which is the as in the classical world, the sum of the powers. And very useful to look at from both sides on the tropical and the classical world. And in the classical world, it is just the linear function, so monomial, with integral coefficients at the variables. So it's a tropical monomial, and the tropical polynomial, again, as in the classical world, is the tropical sum of monomials, classically minimum of linear functions. So it's a convex piecewise linear function. And what differs tropical world mainly from the classical world is the concept of tropical zero. It is a point at which a tropical polynomial, so its minimum, takes minimum at least two times. So the minimum is attained at least two times. So geometrically, one can look at the so tropical polynomial as we discussed it as a piecewise linear function. And so the tropical zero is the point at which this polynomial is not differentiable. Okay. And this was the basic concept, and now the another basic concept is the tropical trivariety. Actually, it is if we have a system of tropical polynomials f1 fk in say in n variables, we can consider the set of its tropical zeros, which is a subset in the n-dimensional real space, as the set of tropical zeros, the set of the tropical zeros. Geometrically, it is a finite union of tetra. And we will denote also the ideal I of F1 Fk as the ideal generated by F1 Fk. And so the tropical trivariety is the set of zeros of semiring ideal. Okay, so what we can do also to extend the ideal. Not the ideal, sorry, but to get more elements of the ideal. As in the classical world, we can multiply by monomials. And because multiplication is addition in the tropical world, so that means that we consider the shift. So we start with a tropical polynomial and then consider its shift by a tropical monomial. And it's an element of the generated by this polynomial. Introduce so fix some n for the time being n capital and introduce n to the power n variables for all the indices between 0 and n minus 1. And we call a linearization, it's an operation, a linearization of the shift, say, of the polynomial. What we do, we replace each monomial by a new variable. By a new variable in the between zero and n capital minus one. And this is similar to in the classical world, what we do, we can consider the vector of the coefficients of the polynomial and consider it's an element of the space of the in the space of polynomials with the basis of monomials. And this is what we do also in the tropical setting. On the other hand, we can consider linearizations as the rows of Macaulay matrix of F. So we consider F, then we consider its shifts, and these shifts are the elements, the rows of the Macaulay matrix of F. So it's similar to the classical situation. Say if we take a point from the tropical trivariety of F, and then we consider the vector of monomials. So these are the monomials of the corresponding to this point, then they are the tropical zeros of the linearization, or they are the solutions of Macaulay matrix of F. So these things are clearly equivalent and similar to what we do in the classical settings. Okay, and now we, basing on this language, we introduce the entropy of a tropical polynomial, or more generally, the ideal. So consider the tropical trivariety un capital. So I remind with that we fix n for the time being, and we truncate the polynomials up to the degree n, that means, and we consider the tropical variety all the points of the linearizations of the shifts. So in other words, the solutions of the Macaulay matrix truncated up to degree n capital. And similar to the classical setting, we define the tropical Hilbert function as the dimension of this tropical pre-variety. Later, I will comment on the relation to the counterpart. Okay, and what we do to define the entropy, we consider the limit of this dimension divided by the n to the power n, so dimension of the embedding space. This limit does exist. It's the proof of existence is the same as in ergodic theory due to the subadditivity lemma. And so the we call it the tropical entropy of the polynomial, of the tropical polynomial f. And this is the real number a priori between 0 and 0 and 1. And literally one can generalize it to from the single polynomial, so from the principal ideal to the arbitrary semiring ideal. What is then the relation to the Hilbert polynomial in the classical setting? Why do all this complicated, maybe from the first look, game? What one does in the classical world? One considers the quotient ring with respect to, say, some classical polynomial G. And one considers the dimension of this quotient ring in the truncated, up to some degree. And this dimension of this filtration is called the Hilbert function in the classical algebra. But unfortunately, in the tropical setting, there is no reasonable concept of the quotient ring. And that's why instead of considering quotient ring, we do this game. So we consider semiring ideal. We consider it is a subset of the space of the all the polynomials, and we consider the space of solutions. In the classical world, it would be the same: the dimension of the space of solutions and the dimension of the quotient ring. But there is no quotient ring, so that's why we replace it by the space of solutions of the Macaulay matrix. And then the entropy plays a role of the coefficient at the nth power. We know that in the classical setting that the Hilbert function is the polynomial. It's called Hilbert polynomial, of the polynomial G. And then the entropy plays a role of the coefficient at the nth power of Hilbert polynomial. But on the other hand, we know that the Hilbert polynomial has degree n minus 1 of the principal ideal. And so therefore the coefficient and n power vanishes. So the entropy in the classical world always vanishes. But in the tropical setting, it is not always the case. Indeed, the entropy can be positive, and then we will see just now a few examples of it. Now we look closely at the univariate polynomials. The first example with the positive entropy is the second degree polynomial, tropical polynomial. With these coefficients, 0, 1, and 0 coefficients, and this entropy is 1 over 4. And Say for the example of the arbitrary degree with tropical polynomial with all zero coefficients, its entropy is one, it's close to one, is one over one minus two over s plus one. And actually, we will see now that these bounds on the entropy are sharp. Namely, that if the entropy is positive, then the entropy is at least 1 over 4. So the first example shows that this bound is sharp. And on the other hand, for the upper bound, if so the entropy is at most 1 minus 2 or s plus 1, as in the second example. So both bounds are sharp, upper and lower bound are sharp. Okay, and now to formulate criterion when the entropy actually is zero, when it vanishes, we need to remind the Newton polygon of a tropical polynomial. So for a tropical polynomial, I remind you that we are talking about Univ polynomials, its Newton polygon is the convex hull of the vertical rays. So we consider the points actually k, ak, and the vertical ray of this point. And we consider the convex hull, and this is the Newton polygon of a polynomial F. And now we provide a criterion when the entropy vanishes. So it vanishes if and only if, first of all, the points, all the points are the vertices of the Newton polygon. So we seen that the Newton polygon is the vertical rays, and these, so we require that first that the these points are vertices of this Newton polygon, and secondly that the indices for which AK, so for which the coefficient of this polynomial is finite, they form an arithmetic progression. So in say in particular, if all the coefficients are finite, that means that all the all the points K AK should be the vertices of the Newton polygon. So this is the criterion of the being of the vanishing of the tropical entropy. And now we formulate the main result on the behavior of the tropical Hilbert function for univariate polynomials. Okay, so for a tropical polynomial with unfortunately this is not in the full generality but only for the polynomials with finite coefficients. So assume that the tropical polynomial has all finite coefficients, and as in the definition of the tropical Hilbert function, we consider the so the linearization and of the polynomial and its shifts, and we so that means that in the in the varied polynomial we consider the following tropical pre-varieties, so if satisfying the all the linear polynomials of these shifts. Okay, and so that means that as in the tropical being the tropical solution means that the minimum is attained at least twice. So we consider the set of the points satisfying all these linear tropical polynomials. And as we agreed, the tropical Hilbert function is a dimension of this tropical pre-variety. Actually, it's a tropical linear pre-variety. And now we formulate the main result on the structure of the tropical Hilbert function. Well, in we know that in the classical world, tropical Hilbert function is a tropical polynomial for sufficiently large points, and here we have a similar picture, but with a difference that is not a linear function exactly, but it's a sum of a linear function and a periodic function with an integer period. We call sometimes that function as the quasi-linear function or whatever. So it's moreover, it's a sum of the linear function with the leading coefficient being the entropy. We discussed that in generally the entropy is the leading is the coefficient at the power n of the as if a Hilbert polynomial. We don't know yet whether it's a polynomial, but if it is a polynomial or something similar, then it would be a leading coefficient of it at the n power, and and the sum of the and the periodic function with the integer period, and this is true for sufficiently big values n. Moreover, we give an explicit bound for it, the period does not exceed also some explicit function. And in addition, in this case, entropy is a rational number. So we know that it's a priori, it's a real number between 0 and 1. And in this case, we can say it's a rational number. So this is the main result. And now a few examples. Well, maybe one comment that in the particular case when the entropy is zero, then we see that this linear function disappears and we have only a periodic function with an integer period. But on the other hand, Hilbert function is monotone; it's non-decreasing, and therefore, the Hilbert function is a constant starting with some value. So it's a constant exactly as in the classical setting. Okay, and now two examples. First example concerns the polynomial which we already considered with the coefficients 0, 1, 0. And in this case, the Hilbert function is the floor function of n over 4. And so its leading coefficient is 1 over 4, and its entropy we have calculated. We have seen it already. And for the another example, which we already considered with the all zero coefficients, the Hilbert tropical Hilbert function is this floor function of the n over 3. And again, we see that the entropy is 1 over 3, as we have already considered. Okay, this was all for the univariate polynomials. And now I say a few words about the multivariate polynomials. Unfortunately, we don't know much here, and here are more conjectures than the results. Okay, so first of all, we define the radical of the tropical pre-variety, and this is so it's a dual gain to the Hilbert strong Hilbert Nullstellensatz. We first define the radical as the semiring ideal of all the tropical polynomials for which vanish on the tropical pre-variety. So in the Hilbert Nullstellensatz, we do it vice versa. We consider the ideal, and then it's radical as the radicals from all the elements. And it's the claim is that it coincides with all the polynomials vanishing on the variety. But here we define the vice versa. We define it's a semiring of all the ideals vanishing on the polynomials of the pre-variety. And this then we the question is on the radical. Well, it's not so nice as in the classical world. It's not just a radical. So the elements, it's more complicated. One can describe indeed explicitly the radical, but it's more complicated and it's not so nice. We defined again the radical of the ideal as the radical of the variety of this ideal. And now the conjecture. If we consider the radical, so they start with a semiring ideal and consider its radical, then the tropical entropy vanishes. And moreover, strong conjecture is that again, if we consider the radical of the ideal, then its tropical Hilbert function is a polynomial of degree at most n minus one for sufficiently large values, again, as in the classical world. So it's then for the conjecture. So the strong conjecture is that for the radical ideal, the picture is completely as in the classical world, so the tropical Hilbert function is a polynomial for sufficiently big values. Unfortunately, in the full generality, it's an open. So these are conjectures, both claims, and I was able to prove a few particular cases. First of all, if we know that V is zero dimensional, so it consists of a finite number of points, then indeed it is true. Then the conjecture is true, and moreover, the strong conjecture is also true. Then it's the entropy vanishes. And three-varied polynomials, as we discussed already, indeed the strong conjecture also holds. So if we have a polynomial which is we have an ideal which is a radical ideal, so if polynomial has no multiple roots, then all the roots have the multiplicity one, then indeed it is true, then indeed the tropical entropy vanishes, and moreover, the tropical Hilbert function is a constant, starting with some value. And another particular case, which is true in the conjecture, is for a plane curve. If we consider plane curve, so a curve given by a single polynomial, and moreover, we have to require that this polynomial is homogeneous, so the coefficients are zeros, then the conjecture is true, so the entropy, tropical entropy of its radical vanishes. Unfortunately, I don't know whether conjecture is true even for a curve, general curve, so for the curve not homogeneous, for the arbitrary curve. And now an example which shows that if we consider not a radical ideal, so actually an arbitrary polynomial, then the tropical entropy can be positive. So if you consider the quadratic tropical quadratic polynomial, then its tropical entropy is at least 1/2. So it's at least positive. Okay. So thank you for attention.
Okay. So now is the time for questions and comments.
Maybe Adina, at some point you mentioned that you compute, you use the notion of dimension, but sometimes pre-varieties, they are not pure, that is, you have cells which have different dimensions. So does the fact that some polynomial complexes are pure play a role in your arguments? Or I understand this is general, obviously. Can we expect something better to happen for pure complex?
The dimension is the dimension of the maximal polyhedra, dimension of the polyhedra of the maximal dimension.
Okay, any other questions or comments? If not, then we thank the speaker.